Start recording now. So the big one already came with pre-cut holes. Oh yeah, you were right, Brennan. I bought these kits already made, like the big ones. I made the small ones. But he was saying, if you pre-cut the holes before you actually soak your hide, all of a sudden it will start to disappear. You could still see them, but they won't be like as prominent as they were. I didn't believe him until I see it now. So that's why I gave you two sets of needles. The one needle, the bigger one, that one will be for the big rattle. And then the smaller one is the Glover needle. So it's made for actually going through leather, which I know most of you are very familiar with that. So we'll do the bigger one first just because it's a lot easier. The holes are already pre-cut, so it'll be easier to actually follow through. So in your kit, I gave you all, I think, three big pieces of sinew. It's up to you. You could decide. The original kits that I bought came with that light color. So you could use that one if you want for the big one, or it's your choice. Doesn't matter which color you use. But make sure you don't split your sinew in half. Keep it all together whole.
Where did you buy your kits, Paige?
At Supplies for the Soul.
Oh, did you?
But they didn't come. So thankfully I had beads at home, because it only came with the rawhide, the dowel, and the one piece of string. And
okay.
The string is not even enough for the whole thing. I was like, So thankfully I went through it yesterday before I came in. Otherwise, I would have been scrambling today actually opening it. Yeah, like it didn't give you the sand, nothing. So I guess you just have to assume and know what you're doing.
It's like, oh, shit. I was wondering what the hell the sand was when you dropped it off last night. I was wondering what the hell. And I'm thinking, well, when you dropped off my my gardener's kit or whatever, it doesn't grow in sand. So the sand is outside my shed.
The sand is for later.
Okay.
You have to fill up your rattle, and that's what's going to give it the shape. And then you're going to leave it sit, and it will dry. I say like by Thursday will definitely be good. And then we'll empty it back out, and then you're good to go. And then after, we'll show you how to put it together. Then, so really tonight, it's just about shaping our rattle, sewing it together, and then pouring in the sand, shaping it out, and letting it dry till Thursday. So it shouldn't be too long. So when you're ready, just thread your first sinew through, and you want to double your thread. So you want your sinew to be extra, like, thick, so you want it to be doubled.
Which needle do I use? The bigger one?
Yeah, use the bigger one.
Okay.
Also, I talked to Brenda Lee about the teepee workshop. And I figured I would give priority to the ones who are in the actual family parenting workshop first. We're going to open it up for 6 spots for the first one. And then after that, depending on the interest, then we'll open it up for another 6 kind of thing. We'll do it that way. So I wanted to give everybody in here kind of like first dibs, since you're participating in this workshop. It makes sense to kind of, it goes along with what we're doing anyway.
What are we doing with the teepee again?
So you'd be actually sewing your own teepee.
Like, so, the little ones there? Those little?
No, like a 12-foot teepee for your yard.
Oh my God.
In our yard? I would love that.
Okay. Yes, so that's
Count me in too.
So she did say, I don't know if you remember her conversation when she was with us last week, it's good to have at least 3 up to 4 people to help you sewing your teepee. Just because the more hands on deck, the better. Canvas is super heavy. Like, I sewed an 18-foot one myself, and that was a lot of work. And it was just me trying to sew on this little machine. So it would be beneficial, even if you had two hands, so you and another partner, that would be really good. So we do have sewing machines that we could use, and we would, I would supply everything for you. You would get your canvas, you would get your thread. Brenda Lee would come and be the facilitator. So it would have to be one full weekend for sure, and then three evenings with a tentative fourth evening just in case. So, because she said it would technically, she would want like full days, but I told her, well, people are working, so it's really hard to get people out of work.
Yeah.
She was okay with doing a weekend and three nights, possibly four. And we're looking at June 5th to 9th. So the first weekend of June, and then those evenings following that. And pending the lockdown.
Yeah, we don't go anywhere.
So like the other thing too, I was hoping is because if we only do six families, they could be very well spaced out in the complex. You don't have to worry about, you know, everybody like convoluting together in a really small space. So I'm still gonna have to talk to Charlene about location wise, but because I don't know how she's going to feel about bringing everybody together in the complex. But that's why I tried to limit it to just to see, like, you know, don't want to have too many. But anyway, so keep it in your head. Let me know if you're interested. And then.
So you just.
Yep.
Put it through like that, right?
Yep. So it's going to be double thread all the way. Tie it off at the
end. And you tie a knot?
Yep. Okay. And remember, sinew is really like slippery. You might need a candle or a lighter just to like burn the end so it doesn't come apart on you. So we're gonna do the big one first. Really hard sometimes to tell what's the inside and what's the out, but the outer side of the rawhide is a lot more softer. And it has more of like a, I don't know how to explain it, defined color. The inside you can actually kind of tell because it's more rough and bumpy looking. So we're going to put the two insides facing each other. So you're just going to put it.
Lost your sound.
Oh, you don't hear me? Hello?
I can hear you.
Hello? Please. You can hear me?
I can hear you too.
I can hear you now.
Okay. Sometimes my internet, you would think I would have good internet being in the city, but
it's horrible. No, mine's saying it's unstable.
So the two smooth sides?
They're going to be facing out. So the rough sides will face each other. Well, I guess it doesn't really matter, but I guess it depends how you want your rattle to look. But they're both equally cut, so it doesn't matter like putting them together. And then all we're going to do is we're just going to do a wraparound stitch. Hold on a second. Brennan, you don't start right at the bottom, right? Because you have to put it in, or do you? Yeah. Eh? Hold on, guys. I need my expertise over here to come and make sure we do this right.
I started over here.
Okay. Yeah, that's what I thought.
To here, and then when it's the next day when you put it in, you gotta keep this wet and sew it again.
Okay. So right over here. So 1, 2, 3, 4 holes in is where you're gonna start. So if you could see that, my needle is about the fourth hole in. Reason for this is because we have to put the stick in there after. And that's the part, it'll be a lot easier to fill it too with sand because we'll have a bigger hole. So what we're going to do is we're just going to do a wraparound stitch. Super simple. Nothing too difficult. We're not puckering. So we don't have to worry about that. So what I mean around wraparound stitch, so I put it through one way. I'm trying to show this here. And then I'm going to go back behind and go like this. Can you see that? See how I started? My needle went through, so I'm always going through the same way. So it's constantly wrapping around the rawhide like this.
Can we pull it tight?
Yeah. Don't pull it too tight where it starts to scrunch up, because we're going to go back around again. Once we come to the end over here, we're just going to go backwards and do another wrap around just to make sure that it's nice and secured on the edges. So you don't want to pull it too tight, but tight enough. If that makes sense. So it does make it a little bit easier with the holes pre-cut. But we have a Glover needle, so it shouldn't be too bad for the next one. And it's smaller. So how is everybody's Monday?
Good. You? Good.
Fast. Time is flying so fast.
I guess, eh?
We have so much to do before I leave. So trying to get everything done at work.
Is Natalie going to be taking over for you while you're gone?
Yep.
Yeah, that's what I figured. Cool.
For the year. So I can still tell.
Well, that's good.
Me while I'm at home.
You won't feel bad about it.
Yeah. No, you're doing that wrong. Me, just kidding. No, she's been pretty good. She's been shadowing me now since last week sometime. So yeah, make sure when you come to the other side, don't go all the way down. Like you want to stop right across from the other side right here. You don't want to sew all the way to the end. Hey, sit on your bum, you're gonna fall.
What, you telling that to Brennan?
So when you get to the end, is anybody at the end yet? Okay, I'll wait till you get there. Hey, Danielle, how'd you do on your moss bag?
I'm not done yet. I'm working on the, what is it, the hat, the bonnet?
Oh, okay, cool.
So slowly, surely getting there.
So you finished the moss bag, you're just on the bonnet? Nice.
So you go to the one that you started, right, Paige? Like to the next one? Like right beside it?
Yeah.
Okay. Like so.
Yes.
Oops. Okay.
Well, these are cute.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we have a small one and a big one to do.
Yeah. So it'll be pretty fast considering, because it's pretty simple. It's not much to do after we have to let it dry, right? Can't really do anything after that, so. Hey, I'm up to here now. Hey. Sally. Mabel, are you almost there? Okay. So when you come to the end, it's hard to show it like this. Your string is sticking out this way. You just want to take your needle and come right back behind that same hole and poke it right through. So it's going to be going out like that. So your string is here. So you want your needle to go through that exact same way. And that's the hole that you ended on, not the very first hole.
Wrapping it around and then through, or just...
So
have it like this.
Yep. Okay. So now you're gonna go on the other side. So you're gonna wrap it around like this with your thread.
So you're putting it through twice.
That same hole. Yeah. There you go. You're putting it through that same hole twice. Thank you.
Okay.
I'll blame that on pregnancy brain.
And then you're going back around again.
Yep. And now we're gonna go back up.
Okay.
Now you're going to go in from like that way, and you're going to go up. So you're going to go to the next hole. So when you go through, it's going to make like that X on this side. You see how it's kind of doing that?
Oh, yeah. Like that.
Yes.
Yep.
Because you want it to make like that X pattern going up.
Oh,
crap. So we're going to be wrapping around now till we come back to here. And then we're done with this one, and we should fill it with sand right away, and then we can move to the next. You got it, Danielle? Oh, you're on mute.
I don't think I pulled my thing through enough to go all the way around.
You can just go back and retighten it, start from the beginning instead of taking it all out. You know what I mean?
Yeah, because then you exit across again, right?
Yeah. So you should have enough to go all the way around two times.
Okay.
There's quite a bit left here for me. Hi, Natalie. Where are you at?
I just got on.
How is your hide?
I put it in really warm water and it seems pretty good.
Okay, well, that's good.
Yeah, I think it's good to go. I grabbed my laptop charger, but forgot my laptop. So I was like scrambling around trying to find something.
So what I was telling them how to start, you don't want to start at the very first hole. You want to start at the fourth hole up. Because you want to make sure that you leave room to put your stick in after. And we're going to wrap that around anyway and make room to actually pour your sand in.
Did you baseball stitch it?
We're just doing a whip stitch, like a wraparound.
Okay.
And then when you come to the other side, you're going to wrap around backwards the other way so it has like that X style.
Okay.
More chocolate milk. Be right back. Yeah, I'll go get you chocolate milk.
I go through the knotted one too, right? The last, the first one that we started?
Okay. Yep, and then just knot it off and then you're done your first one. So Natalie, I was just telling them about confirmation with Brenda Lee. So we have dates booked for the teepee for June 5th to the 9th. So it has to be a full weekend and then three evenings.
Deadly. When do we register?
Well, I said that you guys would have priority just because you guys are already part of the family workshop. So I would probably only have room for one more if everybody here participated.
You'll remind us of the dates again?
Yeah. I'll just send you guys a message in the workshop, like in that chat. So I'll just keep that chat going. Oh, and I also think I found somebody to do star blankets.
Really?
Teepee?
Sorry, what, Danielle?
What weekend is the teepee?
June 5th and 6th, and then it would be 7th, 8th, and 9th in the evening.
Okay.
Yeah. June 5th
and 6th.
And then yeah, I'm writing this all down here.
7th, 8th, 9th in the evening.
In person?
Yes, it has to be in person. That's pending lockdown and to make sure that I do have permission from Charlene to use the complex, but I'm assuming if we're all spaced out because the complex is large enough, I think we should be okay. Yeah, the star blankets. So I did ask my friend Trina and she said that she could, but she would prefer to do that one in person as well, just because it would be really hard to
explain
angles and stuff online. So that's another one that could come up as well. So just keep that in mind.
Amy was the one that asked in Doki's when I had.
Yeah, she was interested.
Who was it? Amy.
Amy.
Oh,
Amy.
Uncle Wayne, yeah.
Okay.
Your Uncle Wayne. And I bought a bunch of fabric for that.
Oh, okay.
I bought like maybe 25 yards, or well, I mean, or more. I'm not sure how many yards are anymore there.
Yeah.
I bought a bunch of fabric for it.
Are you still at the health center?
Yes.
Okay. So actually, well, Vicky and Mabel are on here. Oh, and Danielle, actually, because I talked to her about it too at the sweat. I wanted to try to do something for Aboriginal Day because we can't really do much. And plus, we're not having a powwow again this year because of COVID.
Right. So I'm
thinking if we just did something small with our own community, like our own dancers, and then we can have our own little drum group. We can bring in the guys like Tyler and Brennan to sing with the boys for like a day, because I think Aboriginal Day is on a Monday, I think. And then I'm going to be like that weekend that we're making the teepees, I'm going to make the new teepee for the museum too, so we could even use that to set up, and then we can have like a little mini powwow or something at either the powwow grounds, or we can go to the ball field, we can go somewhere.
Yeah.
Like, something small. And then I was going to ask Chief and Council if they wanted to sponsor fireworks again. And then maybe we could do like a feast, but have already pre-made meals, so people aren't digging in the same containers.
Yeah. Stuff.
So
cool.
I don't know if you guys want to team up and we could plan something for Aboriginal Day.
That'd be awesome.
Mm-hmm. For sure. That'd be really good.
Yeah, that's just some of my thoughts.
Because last year, did we do anything, Paige? No.
Because COVID, that time was still pretty deadly and people just didn't know anything by then, right?
Yeah.
But now the majority of us are vaccinated. Like, yes, we still have to follow the health measures, but I mean,
it's outdoors.
Just pretend we're the United States and we're all open.
Might as well, half country already figures we are, so.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So now are we going to be doing the sand?
Yes. So once you're going to tie it off, you could use your stick to like even open up your.
Which basket. Stick?
Oh, sorry. Just your big one. Because this is the one that's going to be used for the inside after we're done.
Question. So, like, I don't know if you're doing it the same, but so, like, after you're done sewing, you put the sand in, and then you use the rest to wrap, right?
No, you don't do that right now.
But even just to hold it?
Yeah, because you're just going to shape it and let it sit, and then what we're going to do after on Thursday, we'll just have to re-soak it just enough, just to make it a little bit wet again, so that we could re-sew the top and then tie it tight around our stick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I gotta go get my sand in the shed.
So you might want to use something that will help you to put your sand in. I don't know, it might be easier to use like a spoon, or I don't know if you guys.
Oh, okay.
What happened? You gotta change your bum? I think he might have to change his bum. Yeah, so when you're ready, you can just add your sand in.
Until it's full?
Yeah, right up to the rim. And you wanna make sure that you push it down nice and tight, because your sand is what's gonna make the shape of it. Okay. So you don't want it to be like a flat, you wanna try to make it look nice and round, or you know what I mean? As round as possible. I should have bought everybody a little funnel. You could use your stick too to like push the sand down.
So we're doing just filling it now?
Yep, just filling it with your sand. Make sure you put enough in there to shape it out. You don't want to just put enough when it's full, like just use your stick to push it. Otherwise it will be a flat looking rattle. I didn't know that they locked Gordy's sand pit now. I went there to go get sand last night and I was like, oh shit. Sorry, shouldn't be swearing. But
if you go in through the old graveyard road, the old dump road,
yeah,
you know, by the heliport there,
yeah,
you come on top the sand pit.
Oh, okay.
And like it's all like they fixed it all up there now, so no danger of getting stuck or whatever. But if you come in through the heliport road, the old dump road there,
yeah,
you come on top the sand pit there.
Okay, good to know. Yeah,
they fixed it up.
We just went to the old little tiny one across the road from there.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
A little sand hill. I didn't need much sand.
That's where Jaden goes and looks for his, he's fascinated with shotgun shells.
Okay.
Oh,
yeah. Really? So he goes and looks over there for all the shotgun shells.
Oh, really?
got quite the collection. Yeah.
What are you going to do with them? Do you have any plans?
No, he just, I don't know, he just loves shotgun shells. He actually found them. What was that, Jason? 9mm. 9mm.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. It's illegal.
He could make a coat hanger or something. Out of all
his- Yeah, something. How do we know, like, when it's, like, really full? Like,
so, like, I keep pushing it down. So, like, see how it's starting to shape out? It's really hard, right? So, it's, like...
So, I would need more, then?
I just push it and push it until it's hard. Well, I guess it depends on you, like, how you want your rattle to look. If you want it to be more, like, thin-looking, or you want it to be more rounded. Then you just keep squishing down the sand until you figure out like the shape that you like. Danielle, are you still at the school?
Yep.
Okay. Maybe I'll make like an email or something that we could all chat on for the Aboriginal Day powwow or whatever I'll call it.
Okay. A while ago, I did send you my work email.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. You know, another one, Paige, is Brianna Purcell. She's in like with the youth life something.
Oh yeah, the life promotion, eh?
Yeah. She has to do stuff with like youth and all that.
Okay.
Yeah, my work too, Paige. You could probably add us in there too, the mental wellness team.
Okay.
Because we do service Dokies.
Will do.
I think now I gotta try to get this dowel in there, right?
No, so
no.
Maybe if you want, maybe just put your dowel in just so that it stays around. But you don't have to tie it off. Because when it dries, like when your rawhide is dried, you seen how hard it was. So it will keep
it
full.
This is just to shape it, right?
Right.
Okay, it stays in there. It's not into the sand. I just sat it on top.
It should be good. Just gonna add a little bit more. And then once you're ready, you could thread your glover needle to another piece of sinew. And then you could save that piece, that third piece of sinew for when we're wrapping it around on Thursday, because you're not going to need much. So that one should be enough for both rattles.
So when we're done like stuffing it, we just let it dry?
Yeah, so you could just put your dowel, like just lay it on top. So that it doesn't dry your sinew all the way. Like, I mean, your sinew, your rawhide. So you could just leave it sit like this.
Okay.
And just wrap an elastic around it.
Yeah, you could do that. Or you could even tie the remainder of your sinew from the other one, like from when you were sewing it, just to hold it. So then it will keep somewhat of a shape.
because we want it to go around here, right?
Right.
Okay. Yeah. Let's see if I have an elastic.
That broccoli's good.
Whose bus is going round and round?
Oh, I hear that too. Not me. Must be Danielle.
Oh my gosh, sorry.
Is Eric watching his shows again?
Yep. And he owns baby food.
Okay.
The same needle, right?
Yeah. Oh no, you want to use your Glover needle because this one, the little one, doesn't already have pre-cut holes. So we're gonna have to actually punch through.
Oh crap.
See? I just gave you guys the easy one first.
Yeah.
So that one two would be double?
Yep.
Okay.
It might be hard to put your sinew through the small Glover needle now that I'm looking at it because that's just a really tiny hole. Did anybody manage to get their whole sinew through that little hole? Okay, so you might have to actually rip it apart.
Cut it on an angle.
It will go through the whole thing?
Mine almost did. I gotta try it again.
Okay. Let's try.
Oh, no, splits.
Okay, so we'll just split it in half. So when you're ready to go with this one, same thing. You want to make sure, well, obviously these ones will be a bit easier because it has one and two. So you know those ones face the inside. And then you're just going to start right at that corner.
Don't touch, leave that stuff there.
And you can just kind of eyeball it about how far apart you want to make your holes.
We're starting at the same spot again?
Yep. I've never made mini rattles, so these are going to be cute. When I seen Janet's there, I was like, oh, that's so cute, the little tiny rattle. I'm like, we got to make those.
Do you split your sinew for the small ones?
Yeah, because it's not going to fit through that clover needle. I'll be right back.
Yeah,
take your bike. Yeah, go for a walk. Yeah, grab your bike. Maybe put a sweater on so he's not cold underneath that thing.
Yeah, sweater.
Natalie, Warlin finished that whole bag of popcorn before we got home.
It's good popcorn.
He kept saying, thank you, Auntie.
Really?
Yes.
I always have treats.
I think he knows that. Have fun.
Bye-bye.
Love you.
Bye-bye. Were they going for ice cream?
For a walk. Love you.
Bye.
Bye.
He talks good.
How far apart should we be putting our stitches, Paige?
It's really up to you. You could make them like a half an inch. You don't want to go too far. So maybe not like more than an inch, not even an inch. I think that's too much because you don't want the stuff to come out after, like on the sides.
Mine's real close.
Mine too.
Yeah, that's what Mine looks like.
Mine's pretty close. This one, you probably, if you go close, you probably don't have to go back around the other way.
Okay.
Oh.
Know what I mean? Let's go. Let's go. Is it easy to poke through?
No, I'm having a really hard time. Like, I'm still at the beginning because I can poke it through, but I can't pull it through.
You have pliers?
Pliers.
Oh, okay.
I use my teeth.
Oh my God. Glover needle in your mouth every day.
Me too. I always use my teeth.
Oh my God.
All you girls are crazy.
I wouldn't put Glover in my mouth.
I'm not even using pliers. Mine are wire snippers, wire cutters.
Cut your needle in half.
That's the only thing I could find in his little freaking jackpot over there.
Now you said ice cream, Vicky. You shouldn't have even said that word.
Oh, I am so love blizzards.
Oh my God.
You're going for your blizzard?
Probably after this, now she said that.
When we used to live in Sudbury there, we would be there almost 2 to 3 times a day. I mean, a week.
I'm trying to be good. I have gestational diabetes, so I can have lots.
Oh, yeah.
And because I can't, I want it more.
Yep.
Horrible.
Of course.
Holy jeez. It's
like did you have it with Warland? Did you have gestational diabetes at Warland? No.
No. Well, I think I did. I just don't think that they caught it. Because everything that they're explaining about the baby, this like about my pregnancy and how the baby will be when they're born and stuff, was pretty much Warland. So I'm like, like you usually go into labor early. What was the other thing? The babies have a larger abdomen than usual because of the sugar. And Warland, I always thought that was weird when he was born. He had a really big belly. I was like, what the heck? Like, as if I ate that much. But it makes sense. It's because of the diabetes. And I was like, oh, man. And what happens is your placenta, it can't break down. It doesn't have the hormones
sugars
on the insulin.
Oh.
eventually your placenta gives up on you. And that's what happened when I was pregnant with him. My placenta literally started breaking in pieces, and that's why I had to have him early.
Early.
Yeah. Huh. I think I had it. They just didn't catch it. I must have had a good sugar day.
I probably were they feeding the you at that camp?
I know.
I was probably the same. They tested me twice with coal because I swore up and down that I didn't have it. Oops. And then after when I found out that, you know, it was confirmed,
yeah,
I was scared to tell Boomer after. Because I was scared that he was going to give me shit saying, well, it's all... Because what I craved was Coca-Cola, like the pop.
Yeah.
When I was pregnant. And so I figured, well, he's going to give me shit. Well, it's all your fault for drinking all that pop. And, you know.
It's crazy. Because it doesn't matter. It has nothing to do with you.
No.
All your placenta. Yeah. But now it has to do with everything about me. Because I have to watch my sugars and everything.
Mm-hmm.
You're on insulin?
Only nighttime. I can control my sugar in the day, but it's so weird because your targets are way different compared to somebody who has diabetes. So like I have to be every morning between 3.3 and 5.2. Like that's crazy. That was really hard to get in.
That's pretty low.
I know, right?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, I had to take it. Take two different kinds of insulin twice a day.
So will your baby be like in the NICU once it's born until
as long as I can get
like until
their sugar in control. So that was the other thing. When Warland was born, he had low sugar, and that's another sign of a child, like a baby born that had gestational diabetes. So when the baby comes out, I'm probably going to have to supplement for the first bit, like what I did with Warlin, so that they could have the sugars increase to what they're supposed to be. So the baby's going to have his foot poked every like 2 hours to make sure that their sugar.
Yeah. I remember that with the Connor.
24 hours, I think it is. They do it to you for 24 hours.
Yep. Well, when I was with Warland, he didn't have gestational diabetes, but they checked his sugar pretty much right until we left, and we were in the hospital for 48 hours because I had a C-section.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm just assuming it's going to be the same thing. Well, I could go for a VBAC, which I'm hoping for, but that's as long as I go into labor naturally, or I have a scheduled induction. So fingers crossed. If not, then I have to do a C-section. So the baby's for sure coming the week of the 17th, no matter what.
May 7th?
17th.
Oh, 17th.
Oh my gosh.
Wow.
I know.
Because they had asked me if I wanted to be induced or have a C-section because Cole was being born that day no matter what. And I said nope, C-section. So there it was, because he was only supposed to be born, I think it was in the middle of April,
and he came early too.
Yeah, the 27th they had to deliver him because I what was it? They call that preeclampsia or something?
High blood pressure?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That, and I had a lot of protein in my urine.
Okay.
Oh, yeah. Huh.
So, yeah. And I wasn't prepared. I had nothing because, you know, didn't have no bag ready, no nothing. And I was in Sturgeon. Shane had called me. You got to call the hospital. They want you to call. They wanted me there that night. And the baby was being born the next day. I had nothing. I had everything at home and bins and stuff. So I had to get Shane to go through the bins and send some stuff out. I think it was with Shirley and Lloyd.
That's funny. My sister had to break in my house and go pack our bags for nothing ready because I didn't think I was gonna have my baby early.
Yeah.
Yeah. I remember that.
I was bugging her to pack her hospital bag for weeks. And I said, see, I told you.
Now we're ready. Everything's ready.
Yeah. Lesson Your learned. Room is beautiful.
Yeah. Thank you. Yeah, I was like, nope, I'm definitely not doing that again. Holy man.
Like, do you guys know what you're having and just not telling the public?
Nope. No idea.
Wow. I think it's another boy. I think you, what?
I think so too.
Yeah.
How does Warlin feel all about it?
Warlin says it's a little sister.
Every time, oh really?
Yeah, I'm like, Warlin, what are you having? A baby brother or baby sister? Baby sister.
Oh,
so we'll see. We'll see who's right.
It'd be like Mason there when Precious and Nika did their revealing there for Logan. Mason got real mad because he was having a baby brother.
Did you guys find out for Warlin what you were having?
No, he was a surprise. No way.
We didn't find out for Jaden, but we found out for Jacob.
I like the suspense. It's fun.
Yeah.
And it's the one thing, like, you really, you're not going to be just mad about, you know? You're going to be happy either way. You're having a boy or a girl, so...
Are you going back through the second way?
No, I only went through once because I made them pretty close, my stitches.
Okay.
But it's up to you.
I'm going to have a knot on one side and then the other one on the other side.
Well, I flipped it around. So like as if I was going back around again. So I tied a knot.
So you have the knot on the same side?
Yeah. Okay, Niska.
I gotta finish my other the puckering of the other muckluck this week.
Oh yeah, that's this weekend.
Yeah.
I forgot about that. I have to finish my moccasin still. Well, I finished all the puckering. It's just actually sewing it together now. She did say, though, the ones who are doing moccasins can join in again on the weekend if they had any questions.
Yeah, because after we bailed to order, like, since we did the muckluks, we bailed just to order the kit for the moccasins after because it would be taped, right?
Yeah, actually, everything's taped, and I shared all the links on the Facebook page there, so... And what did she say? Are they $175 for the moccasin kits? I think. I'm not sure. I don't remember.
$180, I think she said.
Oh, $180. Okay. How are you on your mucklucks, Mabel?
I didn't work on them at all this week. I should have. I think I might go and see Gwen and pay her to do my puckering just because she does a really nice job and I would like them to look really good. And I don't want to mess that up.
I hear you.
But she did come over and show me how to do it. Like I have the idea now how to, where the thread should be. And like, I mean, but I really like the way she did it. And she did like 5 of them in no time. So, you know.
Yeah, she's friggin' quick.
She's really good at it. Yeah. I think just,
yeah,
I might just get her, ask her to help me and get her to do them because they look really nice compared to mine.
What about you, Danielle? How's your moccasins?
They're coming along. Still on the puckering part, though, because I have a lot of projects going all at once.
Oh, my God. And that's why I didn't join.
Louisa just finished hers, so she's going to help me.
Oh, nice.
Oh, that's good. Oh, yeah, good. Louisa picked that up really fast.
Did she? Yeah.
Even virtually, I was like, holy crap, woman.
Wow. Right on.
Something- I did mine for work when, like, I don't know, just before Christmas. Oh, man. That's why I said, nope, not doing it again. Plus, I already have a pair.
Yeah, those puckerings are.
Yeah.
Pain.
Well, I had seen even Denise Doquiste there was saying she was having a hard time.
Yeah, I seen her post there.
I brought her my awl and she was doing it at work and she had a heck of a time to thread the rubber part on. That was, it's funny, eh? She has like so many pairs of moccasins that she's making for everybody and you know, she has no problems doing that. But then when it comes to using that awl and like she had major problems like getting that concept of that type of sewing.
Well, I was chit-chatting with her today on Facebook and she was saying that she's doing hers and Kathy's.
Yeah.
The puckering or whatever.
Yeah. I brought my awl down there and then a piece of it is gone, like a piece of the awl that holds the needle on.
Okay.
So she's using it, but I mean it's coming apart every time you pull the needle back. It comes apart. Like, so I can imagine like it's very frustrating for her. I don't know if she borrowed another awl off of anybody.
Well, look at Hank broke his needle that day.
Was he born or what?
I know.
That was the first time I produced an awl. That was pretty cool to actually see how like the processes of doing like doing that. I was like, ever cool.
The sewing machine. I heard you say that. So that's how the sewing machine works. I'm going, oh shit, yeah, shit.
Yeah. So she doesn't sew the bottoms on her things anymore.
No, because her son used to do that for her, eh?
Mm. Oh, Jordan.
Yeah. He would come over and he would do all the soles for her. So they would already be pre-sewn for everybody.
Jeez, well, we lucked out then. Holy.
Wow. But it didn't take that long. Once you figured it out, like it was pretty simple.
That part I found was easy.
Mm-hmm.
It's the puckering and that's, I don't know.
And it's when you go from inside, like where your feet, and you come back, and you don't know when you pick your fingers, and
and that needle on the awl is super sharp. The tiniest little poke, and I was bleeding right away.
Yeah.
Holy crap! There's my cute little thing.
Ever cute. These ones are cute, eh? They're so small.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It actually fits.
They'll go good with my baby.
So that's pretty much it. So just make sure that you keep it dry. And then when we come together again on Thursday, we'll just have to soak it a little bit. So maybe before you come on, start soaking just that top part. Try to avoid this. Don't get this part wet because that's going to be nice and shaped already.
Okay. So
you just want to get this part just a little bit wet so that we could sew up the sides. And then when we sew up the sides, then we're just going to wrap it around. We'll do that for both, and then they're done. But we got to obviously pour out the sand and put in our beads and stuff like that.
Mm-hmm. So we wet it when the sand's out of there?
It might be a lot easier to, like, just bend it to get just that part wet. So you can pour the sand out, and then just try to soak only this part. You don't want to soak this. You don't want to soak the ball that you've actually.
Okay.
Yeah. Cool. I've never made a baby one. This is cute.
Isn't this cute?
I love this. Emergency rattle I'm going to keep in my car.
Yep.
Yours is nice and round, Natalie.
Yeah, what the heck? How'd you get yours so nice and round?
Yeah.
I packed it really, really tight.
I freaking packed mine tight. Didn't go like that.
This one's pretty round too, actually. Look.
Wow.
Holy.
I just finished sewing it.
That's okay.
Maybe I need to pack more sand in mine.
Use your little wooden stick to pack it down. That's what I do. Mine's pretty freaking tight, but mine doesn't look that
way. Mine too, but wow.
I know.
And then I shape it too. Like I shape it as I pack.
Oh yeah, okay. Good one. Okay, I'll do that. Maybe I'm not done then.
She wants to go get DQ.
Yeah.
Go faster. Yeah.
Give her any ideas.
So are you bringing DQ the next time you bring the next stuff in for the rest of us?
It'll be all unthawed.
Or you'll eat it by then.
We tried to do Dairy
Queen. Sugar rush.
Yeah, eat it all. We tried to do Dairy Queen on Skip the other day. Everything just came watery, like a milkshake. I was so mad. I was like, nope, definitely not doing this ever again. You've got to
just not. Milkshakes look really good, though. The ones that are on the commercial, holy crap.
Brennan gets the cherry one, and that one's pretty deadly.
I tried the one that you eat there. That what's it called? What's it called, Jace? Wonder Woman. The Wonder Woman in Sudbury? Eh, it is okay.
I love it.
I don't think I'd have it again.
I really love cookie dough and like brown. Yeah. So it's like the perfect combination for me.
I like the cheesecake chunks and all that.
Oh, okay.
Now I'm going to have to really go to North Bay. So we're done then for tonight?
Yep, that's pretty much it for tonight.
Holy.
Super simple. Because we can't do anything else.
Sure, have lots of sand left.
You can go pour it back outside, put it back at the window. Where did I go?
The sand pit.
Couldn't get it any more rounder there, Natalie. I don't know how the heck you did that. So Gwen thinks that we could do all our moccasins in one session because they're very small. They're just little tiny ones. And then on Thursday we have Joseph. He's for sure confirmed. So I made him confirm with me. I have to like call that guy because he's so hard to get a hold of.
And then, yeah, tell me about it.
So he's for sure coming next Thursday too. And then
are we going to be doing puckering with the small ones too?
No. So I have a pair, but they're hanging in my van. They're super simple. They're just, okay. I think they'll all be with hole punched. So you hole punch all your holes and wind it up. Like she has a really small pattern. Very simple.
Yeah, I think I had made a pair like that for Cole and he was small with the hole punch.
I don't know if she's just going to give us all a pattern and then we pre-cut or we cut everything ourselves or if she's going to have everything pre-cut. I'm not really sure. I have to touch base with her. I still have to buy the leather and bring it in. So yeah, but that one is on Monday. Pending there's no baby yet.
That's right.
Cutting everything really close here, guys.
Oh my god.
Even the teepees, like your baby's gonna be like not even a month old.
Sleeping most of the time.
Oh yeah, I guess.
Paige is right in there. Right on. You go, girl.
I did a teepee with Warlin when he was just born. Well, maybe he was a little
bit. Oh, really?
I got my sister to come with me one day, my mom to come with me one day. I think even my grandma was there one day just so I could sew that freaking teepee because I wanted it for his walking out ceremony.
Oh, yeah.
I was on mission.
Do you guys have like regulations in town for stuff like that?
What do you mean? Like for sale? Like,
no, like to build structures or.
So as long as it's not a permanent structure, you're more than welcome to put it up. As soon as
it's permanent,
if it's 10 over 10 by 10, so 10 feet by 10 feet, you have to have a permit. And the permit has to include a blueprint, an architecture design. Like it's really crazy.
Totally.
Yeah.
So you don't need anything for like the teepee because it's like ceremonial and
it's not permanent.
Yeah. Good.
I worked with the city and the fire department to get us a fire permit so we can burn a fire whenever we want, as long as we call and tell them. So they're trying to say like, well, you need to tell us like times and days. I'm like, I can't do that. Like,
oh my God,
it's impossible. So I was like, my time frame, 24 hours, 7 days a week.
No.
We'll just make sure we call you.
You're being honest.
And they're like, okay, fair enough. So
yeah,
that was a few meetings and I just explained to them the different types of, like I had to go and give them teachings and everything about like a sacred fire. Like if somebody passes away, I said, that one's burning for 4 days straight. Like, you know, it's gonna stop. Or if we have a sweat lodge, we're going to have a big fire because you got to keep those rocks hot. So if we're cooking, then we're going to have a smaller fire. You know, it just really depends. So I can't tell you when these things are going to happen.
No kidding.
So, but they were pretty good.
Good.
So it's all done.
That's now. Good.
That was a lot of work, but yeah, at least they're more understanding.
Can you imagine big teepee back here?
Ooh. Well, it's only 12 feet. Just remember, it's not a big.
Oh, yeah, but that's big enough.
Then we have to get
it'll the poles. Yeah, so, guys, so that's another thing. Like, do we have to get the poles?
Well, I was trying to figure out if I could hire somebody or if we could just learn how to do it too, because that would be, that's a lot of
work. Another day. Yeah.
That's like a weekend. Maybe 2 weekends. Pretty.
You and Mabel are gonna set the mic on a warpath over there, teepees in your
backyard. Oh, no kidding. Right in the ghetto. That's what I call our street, the ghetto. Yeah.
But for the teepee, because it's 12 feet, you probably need 16-18 foot poles. So those are pretty big. And you would
what kind of trees?
Black spruce. Or you can use balsam if you wanted to. But black spruce is pretty
nice. We're having a hard time to find black ash, eh, Mabel?
Went for a ride today and Loretta and I were looking, found seen lots, black ash.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You know that trail behind the dump? Is that one Papa say?
Yeah, actually, we went to the dump there. Johnny brought me there today. I went and seen him and asked him about black ash. And we went and seen it. And it has like the little spots at the bottom of the trunk there. Mm-hmm. And so he helped me to identify it anyway. And I was going to ask again about that high bush cranberry. I'm really curious about that medicine that you were making there, Paige. And I'm sure that it's down on the lower front, on the upper French, like by hemlock and down that one. Like five fingers.
Yeah.
Because we used to pick cranberries over there, and I'm not sure it's the same one that you're talking about, because they were high, like they were on bushes, like they, it wasn't in the,
like low to the ground.
It wasn't low to the ground. It was actually off of like bushes, you know. Interesting. So I'm pretty sure that's what you were talking about that time.
I know that there used to be one of them right behind Denise's chip stand there.
Oh, okay.
She's like, you can go back and look. So I did, but I'm like, I don't see anything. She's like, well, I know Roger was back there clearing and stuff. So I think he might have just got rid of it.
Okay. I see.
But
yeah.
Because she said whoever used to live in that house that was behind where the chip stand was,
Jane.
She said that she used to make like the high bush cranberry jam all the time.
Oh, okay. Oh, wow.
That's gone.
Hmm.
Yeah. But I think those are the things he's going to talk about on Thursday next week. I asked him to talk about woman's medicine, because the woman's medicine, those four medicines that you drink, the tea, that's good for as soon as like you're a little girl all the way up until you die, basically.
Helps
you with everything. It helps you with your menstrual cycle. It helps keep everything regulated in your body. It helps you with pre-pregnancy. It helps you with menopause. Like it's the ultimate concoction for women.
Yeah, I need that right now. Like I'm going through a hard time with sweats, like big time. And it's affecting me. Like we went to the Supplies for the Soul there a couple of weeks ago, and friggin' Brian's like chatting. And he's like, did you know your grandfather? And he goes behind the clothes there. And I was like, which one? Who are you talking about? Eli. And then he comes back. And anyway, he was following me around there. And I was like, oh my God. Like, and then he realizes who my mom is. And then he starts speaking Ojibwe to me. And he's making me nervous, like crazy. He's talking to me, thinking I'm gonna understand him, and I'm like, oh my God, I don't understand everything he's saying. So he goes into the other room and he comes back and he has toilet paper, like a roll of toilet paper. he's like walking around me and he's like trying to offer me this toilet paper, and I'm like, get out of here with the He's trying to, because I'm just sweating like crazy, and he's trying to like help me out, eh? Get out of here with that. I said, I'm going to look like I was shaving. I'm going to have like toilet paper all over my face.
That's too bad, eh? Women have to suffer like that.
Yeah, it sucks. It really sucks, especially like, just in a situation stupid like that. But I mean, I was like, get out of here, Brian. Like,
he's so funny, that guy. Oh my
God. Comical. Oh my gosh.
Jeez.
He's sitting around with toilet paper, like trying to help me. Get out of here. No, I don't want that. Yeah. So me anyway with menopause. Yeah, big time. Going them right heavily into it, big time.
Yeah, so he'll definitely talk about that medicine. And then I asked him to talk about when is it safe for young children to start having their medicine. Hi.
Hi.
So he's going to talk about that, because you have to wait, I guess, for their immune system to start building up and all these different things. But FYI, I'm sure you know, he's a very long-winded speaker.
Yeah.
So, well, I'm a book for 2 hours, but he could possibly go for three. Like, he's pretty.
Oh, wow.
It's funny how you, how, like, how excited, like, he's just sitting there. He's like,
like, and half an hour of his sessions will be him joking around.
But he's passionate about it. Like, that's.
Just loves it. Loves hearing success stories, and that's cool.
Yeah. Yeah, he's really cool. He's super knowledgeable. Yeah. Blows my mind how much that guy knows. Like, I don't know, freaks me out.
Yeah. Hey, wow. I went on the weekend. I went to the language conference there, the Anishinaabemowinteg, and that night, Paige, I was dreaming in Ojibwe. We're talking Ojibwe in my dream. It's never happened.
Wow.
I don't think I was speaking it, but everyone in my dream, like, it, the language was in my dream. I woke up, I was like, holy, like, oh my gosh, like, I was dreaming and the language was in my dream. I don't know if I was dreaming in Ojibwe, but the language was there. I was like, oh my gosh, that's never happened to me before.
That's really cool.
Yeah, that was awesome. I was like, yeah. Yeah.
Wow. I only had that happen to me once. And I was like, I don't understand, talking in my dream.
Yeah.
Pulled out a whiteboard and start writing for me in English and writing it out so I knew what they were saying.
Oh
wow.
You mentioned white. I was told that at the language conference before, that when you want to start speaking, you sleep with white. You sleep with a headband of white cloth, and that will help you to start speaking the language.
Interesting.
But I've never been ready for that myself there, but if anyone else is ready, white cloth on your head. Yeah.
Good to know. Never knew.
Yeah.
Can you make it out, Sally?
Still stuffing with sand.
Is he still seeing the back there? Look at him.
He must have had a hard walk.
Yeah.
I didn't bring no ice cream.
Oh, we're going to go for that. Hey, careful.
Heck yeah.
Sally, you're smart. You're using a funnel.
Yeah.
Mine, I'd use a spoon. It was really hard.
Me too.
Are you all done, Danielle?
Yep.
The only thing is that I think that the sand would have been drier. Probably would have had easier time.
Yeah, it was wet when I went and got it.
No, I'm not blaming you. Had I have known, I would have opened a bag. But I thought, well, okay, she's bringing it for the plants. I don't know for what, but.
That's right. Oh, crazy.
Oh, you knew something that I didn't know about planting.
What about you, Mabel? Are you done your rattles? Yeah. Perfect.
Yeah, I'm pretty much done. Yeah. So we can log off.
Cool. Alrighty then. So we'll see you all on Thursday.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. Cool.
Sounds yeah.
Good.
Have a good
night.
All right. Good night. Thanks. Enjoy your ice cream.
Thank you.
Bye. Bye.